So I'm Kat Wright, and I'm the president and actual product formulator for these skincare products. Most women get to a point in their life, either when they're really young and they just get really addicted to skincare, or as we get more mature, we get into looking for skincare, right? So I want to teach you something I think probably most people don't know. There's actually three levels of skincare treatments, right? The first level we know about. So we've got clean skin, got a face wash, and we know about moisturizing the skin, and we know there's some eye treatments, and in today's market, most of us know about serums and how good they are for hydrating the skin, right? So that's the surface of the skin, how we clean it and treat it. The second layer of skincare treatment is transdermal masks. So the patches and the masks that we put on our face, they're actually transdermal, like nicotine patch or hormone patches. Okay. The way that those things work is they kind of suffocate the skin right there in that spot. Okay. And the purpose is to force an ingredient through the surface of the skin, because things don't penetrate the skin really well. We put stuff on the surface and there's a barrier on our body that keeps things from getting in. Some things get through, but that's intended to keep things from getting in. So the transdermal patch, we understand hormone therapy and nicotine patches, but on your face, it's actually trying to force an ingredient past the skin barrier to help build up maybe collagen or the layer between the skin and the muscle. So on your face, the skin and the muscle is actually attached. It's the only place on your body. And there's an ingredient there that we make called ceramides that attaches the muscle and the skin, and as we age, we make less of it, like everything else, right? So as we make less of it, then the skin starts to kind of sag, and then the lines in the muscles show up. And that's the third area of skin that can be treated, is the muscle. So how do you get to the muscle? We know about injections and cutting, right? Yeah. We know about all of that, so we're not going to do that. So first level is moisturizers and cleansers. Second level is transdermal patches. Let me show you this little transdermal patch. These are our under eye gel patches. So they're gooey, feel it? Right? Ooh. Right? They're real soft. But when I put it on my skin, it's going to keep the skin from breathing, and it's going to force the ingredient from the patch down into the skin. So these are, the shape are for the under eye area, right? These are actually reusable. So after you leave them on for 15 to 30 minutes, I mean, like, because I held it, my fingers are real gooey, I usually wipe all this around back on my face because I still want that ingredient, right? So after I take them off, then I take this rose water hydrating spray and I wet the tray, flick it back in its sleeve, put it in the refrigerator, and these are actually reusable until it falls apart.
Okay.
Right? So you can use it 3 to 5 times. It depends on how long you leave it on your skin. Okay, so that one's for the under eye, but there's, I'm not going to open up every one of these of the exact same ingredient, but you can see the different shape here. This one goes on your neck.
Oh.
Right? So it's a transdermal patch for the neck, for the under eye, and this one is for the face. This is the top half of your face. It's like a mask, right? That goes right over the whole face and unfolds, and this one goes around the lower half of the face. Okay? So still we're treating the skin, but we're trying to get a little deeper than the surface with these treatment products. So every day we want to, of course, wash our face, remove our makeup, and get off environmental pollutants and all that sort of thing. And then we want to moisturize, and then you can use a serum wherever, you know, fine lines under the eyes or around the mouth, those kind of areas. If you use serums on those things will progress more slowly and they won't show as much as you age. If you don't moisturize and you don't use serums, then, you know, we've all seen the older woman whose skin just looks leathery and so many lines in the surface of her skin. And that's kind of like buildup that does, there's stuff there that doesn't even need to be there. That's dead skin cells that should come off. If you wash your face regularly, if you moisturize regularly, then those things are just always coming off and you keep a younger appearance. Then you transdermal patch whenever it's convenient. If you do like, you know, whatever, at least once a week, we should have personal day, right? So once a week, it's like close the door and say, leave me alone. I'm doing my mask and my essential oils and meditating and relaxing.
Usually what you recommend for the mask?
Yeah, once a week. Yeah, that would be great. Once a week would be great.
How long do you normally keep them on?
I usually do it for about 15 minutes, but that's just because of time, right?
Oh, yeah.
15 to 30 minutes. After that, you really don't need to leave it on any longer.
Okay.
So what happens when you occlude the skin is what it's called, you cover it up so it can't really breathe, is that the body pulls moisture from the base of the muscle into the surface of the skin, and that's what happens when you have a Band-Aid on for a long time and it gets kind of puffy. Mm-hmm. That doesn't happen here because there's a moisturizer on the product, and it doesn't, you don't need to pull the moisture from the base of the skin, but we still don't want it to dry out and just lay there dry on your face, right? Okay. We want to keep it moist. And only, so about 30 minutes is plenty, 15 to 30 minutes.
I've seen things like this just being sold in the grocery store. Mm. You know, how is this different than what
okay.
we see there?
Well, there are different kinds of masks. Most of those little masks that are sold in the grocery store are like paper. And they have an ingredient on them, but they're a paper mask and they're used one time.
Okay.
These are all just like what you felt here with the eye gels. They're a cactus collagen gel. They have their ingredients, they have something called arbutin. It's made from the bilberry plant, and it is a brightener. So it brightens the skin. Then they have cactus collagen, and the intention is to push that collagen through the and help support the collagen of the face. And they also have niacin, and that increases the circulation. So lots of times, especially under the eyes, the darkness is from capillary breakage. So you get little blood vessel breakages.
Yeah.
And then you have to body has to reabsorb that. So if we can increase the circulation, body will reabsorb it.
Okay,
so those are usually not a gel. They're usually like a real thin piece of fabric that are there's something on them, and there are so many different. Green tea is an ingredient in some of those. Or mostly they're all charcoal. Charcoal is a detoxifier. Green tea is an antioxidant. The ingredients in here are all antioxidants. You know, we throw that word around. Oxidation is what happens to metal when it rusts. So oxidation on the face, the skin is, the cells are being etched away by environmental pollutants. If you cut an apple open and you leave it sit on the counter, it turns brown, it oxidizes. So the same thing happens on the skin, and then it gives an aging appearance.
What an image.
Okay. Yeah.
Okay, so those things are actually pretty common. The third area is the muscle. So with facial expressions, we end up creating creases here or here. Or when we speak or smile, we get lines here. Mm-hmm. And when we're really young, we relax the face and they go away.
Mm-hmm.
And as we age, they don't go away as fast, right? Same thing around the mouth. The smile lines get deeper, or the fine lines around your lips. Now, those are all in the muscle. So none of these products are going to change the muscle of the face. But this product does. So this is a little paper patch. You guys can feel it just so that you have something in your hand. That one that you have is two pieces. I have the one little separate piece. Okay, so this paper patch is just a paper patch with an adhesive on the back of it. The adhesive is a starch base. It's hypoallergenic. It's been tested on millions of women for years and years. So what we do with this, so we have a stat, this is for the forehead line, okay? And I'm gonna tear it into different shapes and show you, but if we have a static line, or you're starting to see a line here, yeah. And I know, perfect, this is perfect for you. And also, good, that's right, when we raise our eyebrows, we get this here like this, well, and then you relax and it goes away, but if we do look in the mirror up close and we go, oh, I hate that line, right? And I'm not going to get Botox. I'm not going to get Botox. Well, you don't have to, but a lot of people go down that road for a long time saying, I'm sure I'm not going to get Botox. And then they just say, I'm getting Botox.
I do it.
Do you?
For my forehead. I have to.
Okay. Well, so these are going to be really great for you to help extend the life of the Botox.
Yes.
Okay. Wow. So I use them all the time, and I've used them for a long time. So I'll start to see these lines, or I'll see my reflection in my car window, and I'm doing that, and I'm like, stop that. Don't do that. You know, I say that to my daughters all the time. They think it's cute to be real expressive. Don't do that. Relax your face, right? So I'm going to, on clean skin, of course, I'm going to massage that line. And if it's static and there's really a line there, I want to separate it, right? I want to be sure that it's separate. I'm going to put this on my face. So I wet the back of it, put a couple sprays of the rose water. That puts an antioxidant treatment on the back of it. And I move the water around just to make sure I've got it all. It
smells really good,
right?
Too.
Yeah, it's essential oil of rose. It's really calming to the skin. So I'm going to separate the line, and I'm going to just apply the patch right here, and I'm going to hold it down. Now, this shape right now is a small triangle. So if I have a little line, that's all I need. But if the line extends up above there, I'm going to take this off before it dries. If a line extends up above there, then I need to make the patch bigger. So this is what you guys have in your hand. It's like two pieces, okay. Right? And I'm going to separate and put it on there. So I have to cover the entire muscle that the line is in, mm-hmm. right? The deeper the line is, actually, the bigger the patch needs to be that I'm going to use. So you see, it's there, and I don't think, I mean, it can peel off right now really easily, but given just a few minutes, it's going to get hard. I'm going to leave it on so that you can touch it and see the difference once it gets hard, because it forms like a splint or cast on the muscle. So I won't be able to, I can't even do it right now. So I can still lift my eyebrows and it'll make it peel off, but I can't bring my eyebrows together like I did a minute ago. It's immobilized the muscle, so I can't do it. Okay, so two things. When I'm sleeping and dreaming and acting in my dreams like I do during the day, I can't squint and make the line worse. Yeah. And the other thing is it's the when the crease happens, the muscle sags like this, skin's following the muscle because it's attached. So I've opened it up and I put the patch on, and it, if I just did it with my fingers and let go, it just falls back in. Well, it can fall back in. Mm-hmm. So it's releasing the tension in the muscle that I created with facial expression. And the first night when you take it off, you'll see a tremendous improvement. But it's not going to last. Okay. Because it's muscle memory, right? If the line's not very deep, then you could wear it three nights in a row and eliminate the line, and it would probably stay gone for 2 or 3 weeks. It just depends on how expressive you are, because you're going to create it and bring it back. Okay. So if you're really expressive and the line is deep, you're probably going to wear these forever. Mm-hmm. You know, you're just going to get used to it, and you're going to put that on at night, you're going to sleep with it on, and then when you get up during the day, you won't have a crease, but you'll still be able to use your facial muscles. So, for extending the life of Botox, mm-hmm. so it's going to help flatten that muscle out, and as the Botox starts to wear off and the crease starts to come back, you're going to just put this on. I'll show you how to do it across the horizontal lines, mm-hmm. and it will just...
Because my Botox does come back uneven, almost. Like, I don't feel like my whole forehead is wrinkled. It'll just be in some certain spots. It gets a little bad here, and then it'll...
Mm-hmm. Be yeah, perfect. So it'll extend the life of the Botox. You won't have to do it as often. This is the same patch. So this little box is called Frownies Facial Patch for the forehead and between the eyes. So this is like, of course, between the eyes. This way, I've torn it. There's 1, 2, 3, 4 patches, and I could put this whole thing on here and cover the center and the horizontal, or I can just get rid of the, if you don't have a line here, right? If you don't have a line here, then I can get rid of the little point, and I can just put it across here. So if the lines are horizontal, a little adhesive left on my forehead, but if the lines are horizontal, then you just want to separate them this way, right? Wet the back of it and stick it on there. And nice. Then, and if I got adhesive on my forehead, let me put it on, because you can see I lift my eyebrows a lot when I talk. I was actually a swim coach for little kids. I was outside in the sun a lot, and instead of squinting, I always thought it was better to lift my eyebrows. So I trained myself to lift my eyebrows and wear my sunglasses, right? But anyway, so you separate that little line there, right? And apply this over top of it and hold it on for just a second. It's really a strong adhesive, but it's plant-based. If you have sensitive skin, then we just suggest that you maybe try it on the inside of your wrist first and see if that bothers you. But rarely have we had any problem with that. So now... like you can see, I'm trying, I can't lift my eyebrows, and it's not even really dry yet, right? So that'll immobilize. So I sometimes garden with it on and just, you know, like do that, or I'll wear a hat because I don't want to get a suntan mark with my frowny facial patch on my forehead. So there, this box is for the forehead, and this box is for the corners of the mouth or the corners of the eyes. So it has two different shapes in it. This little shape is like a butterfly wing, mm-hmm. okay. and it goes right around here like this.
Okay. And these lines here?
Yes. Okay. And then on the outside corner of the eye, now this is not in the eye socket because the skin's not attached to the muscle on the inside of the eye socket. Only like on the side of the face and the cheeks and the smile lines and the forehead. But when you get inside the eye socket, that's where we want to use the under eye gel patch and a good eye cream treatment, right? But what I noticed was when you lifted your eyebrows, mm-hmm. lift your eyebrows, see the little mm-hmm. curve? Turn so that she can see you. See that little curve?
Oh, yeah.
Okay, so these are all the same thing. They're just different shapes. This would be perfect right above your eyebrow.
Interesting.
Right? Because your little curve, when you lift your eyebrows, right. So this one will fit really well right over your eyebrow.
Okay.
Okay? And that's going to lift the base out of the muscle. So there's not really a hard and fast rule. It's just if you're only going to use them on your forehead, most of the time, these little triangles work best.
Yeah.
Right? So that's just how that product's been named for years. But you can use it anywhere on the face, just not inside the eye socket.
And overnight.
Or gardening. Or riding a bike. Or whatever. Right. Anytime. Actually, I also... The people who work here, of course, that work for the company, they all know what this is. They wear them all day long at work. They're working on the computer. They're right. doing whatever work they do. The women, anyway. We can't get the guys to wear them yet.
Right. You know? Can I feel how...
Yeah. I want you to do that. Tap it. It's like really hard, right?
Wow.
Isn't that amazing?
Yeah. It made a stiff...
It's like cardboard.
It's surprising, isn't it?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
So this is really soft, but when it firms up on your face. Now I don't really feel it there, but I didn't put it on here because I wouldn't be able to talk to you. It wouldn't stick. I keep smiling, moving that muscle, right? But you can put them on right before you're going to go to bed, right? And you put them on and you go to bed, and they pull this muscle forward. There's another patch that we recently, maybe 5 years ago, added to the line. We called this one a gentle lift. It works on the same theory in that it's splinting the muscle and lifting it, but people took this and cut it to fit different shapes around their lips because we get those lines there. Mm-hmm. And then the edges of this paper in the small areas, it was kind of too much. Mm-hmm. So we created this little gentle lip, and it's self-adhesive. You don't have to spray the back of it. And they can be, all of these can be pieced together. Actually, I'll show you that on my forehead too. But these can be used right here for lip lines. So you just kind of separate the little line and apply it here, 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 and here. But you also can use them, like some people just get a little dimple line. These are easier because they're small for me to put on my face and talk. But you can put one on and another on and follow your own line. So you're creating your own shape. Whatever shape you want that to be, and then it lifts that little crease forward.
Right.
Okay.
So if you have like just a stray line somewhere here, that because I have, it seems like I have a line here when I wake up in the morning that goes through my eye and ends like right here, and I have no idea. It's not when I sleep on that side; it's just always there in the morning.
Huh. So this would be perfect for you. This would be perfect for you to just put over top of that line and see that area and see if it lifts that line out for you in the morning.
And then I have the lip lines because I always drink out of a straw. So when you drink out of a straw, then you can see all those fine lines.
Yeah, you try to protect your teeth.
Right.
And not make your teeth yellow, so you use a straw, and then you wrinkle your lips.
Smokers have those, and I said, well, I don't smoke. And then I realized it's from the straw.
That's right. And that's where these are perfect for that. And that's what we generally say. Drinking through a straw or smoking, create those lines, you know. But even just some people, just the way you speak and the way you purse your lips and however you use your facial expressions, then you get your own little curve right above your eyebrow.
Thanks for pointing that out.
Well, you know, we're here talking about it.
Right. No, it's good.
So if, you know, like I have here, and I don't have a mirror in front of me, but, you know, you could say I have these lines here. I could have lines underneath that. And so I can just piece these together, right? And if a line is really heavy, I think I would probably go this way so it's narrower at the bottom. But if a line is really heavy, you can just overlap these and they're even a stronger splint. But you want to be sure that you're covering the whole area that's going to make the expression, right? So if I'm going to lift my, now I can't move my forehead. So it's really, for me, because I do that, here's the other thing. I do that, just speaking. If I have these on, I notice that I'm trying to do it. Right. And so it reminds me to relax my facial muscles.
Oh.
Exactly.
But they're one use and done.
These are one and done because, very good question, thank you. How am I going to get this off my face, right? One thing is I don't want to put it over my brow because it's a little bit like waxing, right?
Okay. Yeah.
But if you put water on it, it gets soft and it comes off. falls right off, right?
So we don't want to peel them off.
I did that, and I do that, but I've gotten used to it. My muscles are relaxed. When you first start, it seems like it really holds on stronger,
okay,
right? Because it's your muscles pulling against it. So I really advise people to soak your face down. If you take a shower in the morning, it's great to just leave them on, get in the shower, and they'll just fall right off,
okay?
So the other thing is I told you about in the beginning about occlusion, like sealing off the skin so it can't breathe. Because these are paper, they allow the skin to breathe. So when you take it off, it won't feel puffy or mushy or anything like that.
Okay.
So you wash your face, you still apply your moisturizer. The Frownies moisturizer for face and neck is a gel cream with an aloe base, and it'll penetrate into the skin really quickly. And you can put this right on over top of it. And so you've got a treatment product underneath there, because sometimes people say, you guys, none of you have said it, but what makes it work? What's in it? Nothing. It's strictly mechanical. So okay. I hope I got that across, because it's just a mechanical process.
Yeah.
It's a mechanical process that created the wrinkle, and we're talking about the muscle, right? So we did skin, transdermal treatment, and now we're talking about the muscle. And you still want to do a treatment, and occasionally using the transdermal treatment is a great addition just as we mature.
Yeah. So how early would you put that on before you get in bed to make sure it's secure and it doesn't, like, you wake up and it's by your ear or something?
Right before you go to bed. Right before you go to bed, because this is, like, on there, right? And we haven't been sitting here for very long, and it's really there. And the same thing with those. I took them off so I can talk, right? But the same thing with the gentle lifts. They just put them on right before you go to bed. And it's good. And it's a process. You're not going to put them all over your face right at first. Pick an area, work on one area, and then progress from there and see how it goes.
So nothing like from the corner of the eye under at all, like where my glasses are.
Right. The gel patch. The gel patch.
That's a 15 to 30 minute process.
And let me show you, see, this is really cooling and you can adjust it.
But it would feel so good.
It feels great. So you can pull it up here.
It's even.
So it's just like that, one on each side.
Okay.
Right? And I always, with the transdermal patches, whether it's the neck or the under eye area or the full face, I always wash my face first. And I still put my moisturizer and things on, because this is helping the moisturizer get in as well.
Okay.
So all of the Frownies products, the skin moisturizing products, one of the key ingredients is an oat oil. And that's because oat oil is the only thing with ceramides in it besides our skin. So the oat oil, and it's very, very high in natural vitamin E. The vitamin E, the ceramides, they kind of get past that first layer, and they do have a just slight plumping effect. So some of the fine lines around the mouth or under the eyes, by just using the serum, you can fill that in slightly.
Okay.
If you want to feel it,
yes,
you take a little bit. I don't want to put too much on your hand, but even if you rub it on the back of your hand and feel it, it's really smooth. You can put it on your face if you want, but you'll have all of these things to work with, and this is fantastic under the eyes or around the lips. You can use it on your whole face, but under the eyes and around the lips. It's high in naturally occurring vitamin E and vitamin C, and then the oats with the ceramides in it.
And you would put this on and then put the patch over it.
Mm-hmm. Give it a few minutes to soak in. So, to your question, when do I do this? Do that first,
okay.
And then right before you go to bed, go ahead and put your patches on over top of it.